Rock Gang, man, what is poppin'? Alright, y'all. So basically, DJ Akademiks just posted something about since I was 6ix9ine, he got into like some fight in like with his crew or something, like just straight jigaboos and coons and activity that are not good. So don't do it. Don't do any of the activities that are here. But we're about to listen to it. We're about to figure out what happened. Why these angry freaking black people got mad. God, well, God dang, that's why I can't take black people anywhere. Look at them. Straight, just, Like, why? They're just fighting in the middle of the street. For what? Exactly. What? You have all the bread. Why are you fighting? Like, what? Anything anyone says to you doesn't matter.
Nigga 6ix9ine in the street getting fucked up.
The dude commentating, bro. I'm weak as hell. Yeah, a whole lot of coon. Yo, he just weaved the mess out of that. Damn! Oh my god!
How many times I gotta troll y'all niggas, man? How many times I'm making fun of y'all niggas, man? Y'all see my shit spinning, man. Look at my face. Still untucked, yo. Beautiful, luscious shit, man. Yo, niggas just pack some niggas out. We just force some niggas at the airport. As soon as I get the video, I'ma upload it.
Still untouched, man.
Stop playing with me. I told that nigga, stop playing with me. Y'all can't touch me, nigga. Look at this one more time.
Dude, that's some ignorant coons. Y'all can't touch me. You can't touch me.
San Antonio tomorrow, man.
Every
fight was staged for promo.
Every single like person thinks that they're untouchable. Like, I don't understand the mindset of thinking you're untouchable because anything happens, to tell you the truth. But that's enough of me talking. I don't know why I'm saying anything. Let's get it.
For the project release on Friday.
Oh,
this is not, it wasn't staged. Stop saying it was staged.
When
I don't get touched, y'all niggas be mad tight, nigga. Actually, the nigga was gushing. He was bleeding from his face. Like, he's not staged. Like, why I gotta stage something for an album release, nigga? My shit gonna sell.
Why I gotta stage? I knocked that. No.
Look at my face.
Ugly ass.
Check it out. Now, oh hell, motherfucking no! They caught him lacking, people. They caught him lacking. Now, let me tell y'all this, man. When Tekashi 6ix9ine announced that he was basically on a Test My Gangsta tour, I thought that any nigga who tested his gangsta was about to taste the fucking rainbow. Okay, now he was in LA. It was
he said, "Taste the rainbow."
2 hours later.
Basically a game of finding Tekashi. Where the fuck is Waldo? Okay, it was basically, where's Waldo on some finding Nemo shit. Everybody was looking for that motherfucking nigga with the rainbow hair. Now nobody can catch him. He announced, y'all believe in LA. Now everybody said, damn LA, man, y'all actually caught L on this one because y'all can't catch Tekashi. However, there were some diligent motherfucking goons who were circling the airport like goddamn TSA. They were looking for Tekashi, and I'm getting reports that they were driving around LAX since Saturday. Okay, no hours missed, 24 hours in search of Tekashi 6ix9ine. And basically, you know what happened? They caught this motherfucker a day after he announced he left, but he didn't leave. He fronted his move. He actually was trying to leave the next day. They caught him going into the terminal. They ran up, so and basically, they started popping shit at Tekashi 6ix9ine. And this was the time for Tekashi 6ix9ine to say, hold up.
These fools fought at an airport, acting like they don't have security and cops.
Chain on my man, and let me give you this fade. However, if y'all remember his hit song, okay, his hit song Gummo, he ain't mentioned nothing about the hands. He got a line that say, listen, pop these niggas like a willy nigga, you a silly nigga in the hood with them billy niggas and them hoover niggas, you run up and they shoot niggas. He ain't got no lines about they run up and we fading niggas. The hand game wasn't right. Okay, now I gotta call a spade. Tekashi's actually my guy, but he gonna catch a lowercase L in this situation because here's the thing. Let me break it down. Somebody comes up, start talking shit to you. I get it. You're the rapper. You're the rich person. You really don't fight. Same way how
exactly. We
never fought. Okay, you have the chases. Do the chasing. But here's where you fucked up, because you had five people with you. And by the way, I got an issue with that low key. Okay. You can't pop that much shit and only roll with five people. Cardi B didn't pop as much shit as you. She went to All-Star Weekend with 40. If I'm Tekashi, I'm getting getting 50,000 per show, I'm bringing 50 niggas to LA. Okay? Each of y'all get $1,000. I don't even want to get paid. This is the just keep me safe tour. Okay? But whatever. He's on this test my gangster tour. Here's the thing. So somebody's popping shit. Your mans is handling that. By the way, Tekashi's team hooked off, as they should. Solid niggas. They hooked off. They were about to body them niggas. Now, they actually pushed Tekashi to the back because they're basically saying, Tekashi, when it's time for action, that's where we come in. Step in.
Okay?
Now, Tekashi really jumped in, and it didn't help him. That's why
he's stupid. All
right? He could have just stayed in the airport and filmed it and talked some more shit.
Coon ass.
And yes, that's your
Jigaboo ass.
But he wanted to get some gangster points. So he tried to jump in the fight.
God,
except I saw him swing like 3 times. He might have connected once. And then somebody tackled him and punched him a couple times. So and also he fell. Now, of course, his mans then came in and, like, got that nigga the fuck up all out of here. And what I'm hearing is that the niggas who actually, like, punched him, like, they got really fucked up. A lot of blood in people's faces might be dislocated. But well, the team caught the W. But the Test My Gangsta tour? I don't know if it's Test My Gangsta if you're not making niggas really respect and taste the rainbow. You gotta be giving these niggas them hands, okay? And he didn't give nobody the hands. So his team called the W, but I gotta give him the lowercase L. And this is the reason why he should have just fell back in the goddamn airport and not do anything. Because if you jump in the fight, you gotta really turn up in the
stupid
fight.
Now,
here's the thing. The cops did come. And by the way, this is a blessing that this happened at LAX, all right? Anywhere else, somebody might have had a pistol. Anywhere else,
exactly.
Somebody might have a pistol. But at LAX, niggas know what time it is. You're going to have to use fists. It might be a blessing and a curse, because maybe these niggas can't fight. They just shoot.
That's a fact. He really might have gotten blessed. This is why you can't do stuff like
maybe
this,
bro. Maybe favorable in whoever's outcome. Or
whoever. People be killing people now. Stop, right? Y'all need to stop.
But
stop.
The cops basically, of course, are going to get involved.
Man, killing
surveillance footage, and people got recording shit that they're
stupid.
TMZ. Now, the guys who were fighting Tekashi, they dipped. And the police talked to Tekashi and his crew. Nobody got locked up. Luckily, no charges are being pressed. Of course,
well, I'm not surprised.
When he goes back for his probation check, they will be mentioning this, like, bruh, you've been doing a lot of shit talking online. Also, you're getting into fights. We're not too sure if probation's working out for you. Okay? However, he didn't get locked up. He was allowed to go on his merry way. And all I'm going to say, Tekashi, you got to get him hands game right, bruh. Okay? I know you got your mans that will protect you. And by the way, that's really all you need as a rapper. Like, most of these rappers really can't fight. We've seen the boxing videos. But Tekashi, if you're going to jump in the fight, you got to jump in on some Mike Tyson shit. You got to be knocking niggas out. You got to be the nigga that they say, I don't want him to hop in. If you're telling people to test your gangster, okay?
If he says on some Mike Tyson.
You got to make sure your hands game is right. If you want people to try to fuck with you, well, just keep enough people around you, okay? So the only reason I'm giving him a
little
Mike
Tyson
is he hopped in a fight and didn't have to.
Superhero.
And then he didn't do no work. He didn't do no damage.
People
okay?
That know me well,
I'll give him some points for bravery.
Know what I mean,
because I
would have
definitely chilled inside eating popcorn, sipping on soda,
on
and probably recording them niggas getting beat up by my team just that I could tell people don't fuck with me. However, he decided to jump in the fight, but when he jumped in the fight, he did not really do nothing for us to say his gangster was tested and he came away with an A+. He kind of got like a maybe a C minus, but his team got an A. I ain't gonna lie to you. Give a guy box, you guys like, hey, if you want a full video, I can't put up all the videos here. Listen, TMZ owns some of the videos, but they're all on my Instagram. Follow me right now on Instagram. All right, link is all in the description.
I think that ends it. He's basically just plugging. Yeah, so dude, DJ Akademiks is the GOAT. I love all of his videos, basically. I've subscribed to him a lot. He's tough. Y'all need to go check him out if you're not already hip. He does hip-hop 24/7. But anyway, basically, with this, dude, DJ Akademiks is 100% right. Like, he has no business fighting. Like, you have all the money. There's no reason for you to be fighting and risking that. And risking yourself, risking your freedom, because you can go to jail for this. Like, there's no point. It's stupid. Yeah, just have your goons, have your jigaboos, go crush some fools like some Mike Tyson, but don't hop in it like a freaking bruh, it's just so dumb. Alright, y'all, man, I hope none of y'all are fighting. None of y'all better be fighting, man. I swear, bruh, I'm gonna have to come over and smack. It's like, alright, y'all, If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to hit that red button. Matter of fact, just uppercut it real quick. Join the family. It's a movement. So without further ado, take it easy, fam. Peace.